I'm Richie Wilcox. I can probably describe myself in three words, or three-ish words. I'm a Cape Bretoner, I am a queer person, and I'm a theater artist. I'm a theater artist, I'm a theater director, singer, actor, many different skills in theater, as well as a teacher. And I'm a queer person, which means that I'm an activist. I think it was grade 7 that I first started doing theater, actually. I did The Music Man with Fred Penner. And then continuing on, I think it was in grade 9 where I was making the decision already that young that I know what I want to be when I grow up. I want to be a theater artist, which scares your parents, of course.
Following this early aspiration, Richie earned his degree at Dalhousie University in Halifax. During his third year at Dalhousie, Richie was mentored during a directing course by David Overton. From that point on, he focused primarily on directing theater. After his graduation, Richie co-founded an independent theater company called Angels and Heroes. For 5 years, Richie helped manage Angels and Heroes to much acclaim. However, at this point, he felt as if he had reached a plateau in his career, and he pursued his master's at the Texas State University.
And after that, I came back to Halifax and I directed a show called I, Animal. Circumstances led to me being able to direct a Daniel MacIver piece, a world premiere of a Daniel MacIver script. It went awesome. And there was some really great performances in it. People were nominated and won for sound design and lighting design. I was proud of it. The challenge was when we went to Toronto with iAnimal. One of the lead actresses in the show is also the producer. It ended up being that this actress started stepping on my toes, stepping on my directing. Between Halifax and Toronto, the sound design changed, the lighting design changed, because not of my choices, but because of her choices and because of her intention of where she thought the play should go. I almost thought of dropping my name out of the show, which is huge because this is a Danny MacIver world premiere now in Toronto, which is the leading theater center in Canada. And I didn't, which is where I failed, because I should have either stood up or left. But I just let things happen and went along with it. And then the show flopped. So that was a major failure, but a great learning lesson.
Sometime after the Toronto premiere of I, Animal, Richie Wilcox left behind the city and his teaching position at York University. Stifled by the disconnected interactions there, the scrutiny of the theatrical community, and his own failure with the I, Animal premiere, Richie embarked to Lethbridge, Alberta for a 9-month teaching program to start anew.
I didn't realize how religious Southern Alberta was. The contrast and the sort of like bumping of heads between these communities, between these different values, I think can be really fruitful for art. And so in Lethbridge, that's what I found with the Bible Belt, that there's values that I have that are completely against values that the person sitting next to me has. And so we can have this discussion and debate, but we can also have that discussion and debate through art. And that's, I think, why Theatre Outre is doing so well here. We've now had numerous successes, and one of our first ones was Unsexed, which was right after I, Animal. And I was definitely feeling a bit tentative about directing this piece. And I think that piece, Unsexed, really helped rebuild my confidence in directing, and that has been, I can say, an international success.
It's not all artistic pursuits. At University of Lethbridge, Richie is a familiar, friendly face.
I've taught numerous courses now, whether it be studio courses or courses for 200 people, lecturing them 3 times a week. Those are great challenges in learning how to do a 50-minute lecture and learning how to make it entertaining and relevant to people that might not even care about drama, and hopefully sharing my love and passion of theater with them. The opportunity to get to know students and to be mentors to them and to actually help lead them through this crazy time in their life and try and find careers and try and find the right choices for them in this moment, you end up, for some people, you end up acting like a second parent.
You may wonder how a career this lucrative could possibly get any better, but Richie has yet another bold step to make.
Oh, yeah, I'm writing a book. Sorry, that's what we're talking about. Great, yeah. I thought we were talking about the club, that I run a gay club, which is also not a part of like my life goals, but here I am. But the book, yeah. So with Danny McIver, it's interesting that I was focusing my dissertation on him with my PhD that I had started to pursue, and I failed with this premiere of his show. And then I'm stuck still doing research on him. And that's hard, because you're kind of like, I just want to take a break from this person and from this artist, but you're focused, and your focus is already chosen. And then I get this offer to edit a book of essays on Danny McIver, which was huge, because I've never edited a book before. I don't have a book with my name on the cover of it yet. And also, there's no academic book on Danny McIver, so this would be the first book of this sort, which is really big in the academic world. It's so awesome. I remember looking at the cover that was sent to me by Playwrights Canada Press, the publishing company, and they're like, does this cover work for you? And I'm just kind of like, that's my name. So it's really exciting.
Richie's book will be available in May. He has dedicated it to his mentor, David Overton.
So what's next? I will finish my PhD. I will write that dissertation. I'm chapters in already. I will have that done by next year. That's the plan.
I think we have one more question.
Oh yeah, we have one more question. This is very important, so like think hard about this one, okay?
This is the most challenging.
Yeah. Just be ready for it. What's your favorite play?
I want to talk to you.
What's my favorite play?
I promise you it won't happen again.
Do I attract you? Do I repulse you with my queasy smile? Am I too dirty? Am I too flirty? Do I like what you like? I could be wholesome, I could be loathsome, guess I'm a little bit shy. Why don't you like me? Why don't you like me without making me try? I try to be like Grace Kelly, but all her looks were too sad. Tried a little Freddy. I've got an entity mind.